got into an accident and couldn't come to school. But when he finally came back, his hair had turned from black into bright white.
Hello there, it's Saturday the 6th of September, a week before your birthday, and I've made this video to find out exactly what you mean to everybody. I'll be interviewing everybody in the next week. Hope you enjoy watching it.
Family is a lot of things to a lot of people, but to me, you know, he's my friend, and I know I'm going to find it hard to get over this. It's not exactly the sort of thing.
Tom. This video is about Laura. So, Spud and Luke, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Hi, Laura. Alright.
Sorry, I don't mean to be. Carry on.
Laura Martini means a great deal to me because she's been a great friend to me over the years, and I've always had her there to talk to me when I'm in need. It's, you're like a Samaritan, really.
She is.
Yeah.
She's
just a great friend. I've always had laughs with her. Especially laughing at her in the morning when she's tired and chewed up.
it's true, yeah.
And at lunchtime and stuff, we've tish and cow.
Good. All good.
Any memories you want to remind her of?
Yeah, at Rosie's that time. That was funny, that night. Oh, that sounds really dodgy because no one else knows
anyway.
No, carry on
first. I remember when our first festival together, me, you, Rosie and Harry. So, and that was a good laugh. We watched the Foo Fighters on that Saturday night, I think.
What?
We went to Shropshire as well, I think, before that.
Clearly before that.
Anyway, and I sat across the table from you and Rosie. And I tried to make myself look good by drinking milk with sugar in. And, yeah.
I think you do for your love.
I remember being in a math class, Miss Edgers. And, I remember I did have a little crush on you, though. Now I've gone red. But, you're always there when I need to talk to someone. And the one best memory was after me, Southampton getting relegated. So...
Yeah,
Luke.
Nice of you to remind her of that on her birthday.
Oh yeah, happy birthday, Laura.
Yeah.
And I hope you have a great day.
I hope you actually thought of something to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, but by the time she's seen this, she would have...
Oh no, that's why I said thought. Future tense.
Yeah, future tense.
Past, she would have seen this after her birthday. Or on.
I think that was past tense.
I don't think she wants a video of tenses for her birthday.
Maybe not. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Laura. Happy 16.
Okay.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
Mwah.
Thank you very much for your time, lads.
Alright, good.
So, Tom and Ryan, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Well, we're going to tell you through the medium of song.
So Sarah, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
You mean a lot to me, Laura. We've been had a good time. You're lovely. You're really, really fun. You're always happy. I love you, Laura. Please do.
Is there any memories you'd like to remind her of?
Fish shopping. That was funny. Walking through Lidl with fish. When you got dressed in middle school and you turned full of yellow bit clothes and tear yourself up. Manoeuvres in the plastic dumpster. That's good. Spread the birds that flew into the windows. Yeah.
Is there any birthday message you want to give her?
Have a really good day. I'm really sorry I can't be there. I'm sad. Have a good day.
Okay, thank you very much for your time, Sarah. Bye. So, Bradley, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Laura Martini? Oh, she's a good friend. She is. And the funniest thing about her is when she wakes up and she's all like... But if you wake her up, she will get angry. But I've got a list here of the things you can do, Laura. That's right. Things you can now do that we can't, and you can shove it in our faces. That would be very nice. Right, here's one that I know of by heart. You can get a lottery ticket. Yeah, you can go to the shop, say, hey, oh, a lottery ticket, I'm 16. Yeah. Okay, so you can do that. You can work full-time. You can do that. You can claim certain benefits and get national insurance number. Sure, national insurance, that'll be good. Generally, you can leave home without the agreement of your parents. You can just, well, look, in fact, you could go to the park. You could sleep in the park if you wanted to. If you want to sleep in the park. If you're a girl, you can choose to have sexual intercourse with a man without him committing a crime. So you can have sex with Lewis, but if he's committed a crime, you can't have sex with him, apparently. That's fair, really. If you're a male, you can have sex with a guy if you want to. I'm not sure if you're... You can get married, written, but you have to have written permission. You can buy liquor chocolates. I've never heard of liquor chocolates before, but you can buy liquor chocolates. I think it's got chocolates with alcohol in it. You can join trade unions. You can choose your own doctor. You can gain access to your school records. That's good. You can apply for your own passport. You can apply for legal aid on your own. Don't know what that is, but still. You can have a right to a youth training place. Forget that one. You can join the armed forces, that'll be good for you, Laura. Or like, and you'll be like, kill some Iraqi. Taliban. Yeah. You can get a license for a mopped moped or invalid mobile. Hey Nathan. Okay. You can have a beer, cider or perry. You can have a full fare on trains and buses. Oh, that's not good. You can buy premium bonds, you can become a street trader, and most of all, you can become a pilot of a glider.
Brilliant, Bradley. Brilliant. Thank you very much for your time, Bradley. So, Michelle and Louise. What does Laura Martini mean to you?
Laura's cool. Laura's a lot of things. She is. Happy.
She's cool. Yeah, yeah.
Trendsetter. Agile.
Kind.
Kind, yeah. She can cheer people up. She can. But most importantly, she's a friend.
Right, is there any memories you'd like to remind her of?
Oh god, loads. Where do we start? You go. Allow me. First of all, Laura, remember our little 2-hour trampoline marathon? How weird was it? All those things came true, huh? Louise? Yeah. Shropshire, that was a good one. That's great, sharing rooms, getting us in the costumes, getting to write 2 pages of essays, you know. Yeah, that's good, yeah. Oh, I have a little rasta phase. I can't not mention that one. The one got my Jamaican flag on my wall behind my bed. Oh, it reminds me of you, Laura.
Is there a birthday message you want to tell her?
Well, Jeff, happy birthday.
I hope you have a great day.
Sweet 16.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, have a fab one, Laura. Mwah!
Okay, thank you both of you very much for your time.
Thank you for your time, Nathan. It's
great.
Yeah,
cheers.
Bye, Laura.
Bye.
I love you.
So, Canker Blossoms, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Laura. Well, Laura's like a good album. Like our album. You can buy it in any good store. Any good store. Get it on the internet.
Or download it.
iTunes. Download it from iTunes.
No. I prefer TorrentBox than you, TorrentBox. It's much easier, I think.
No, if we steal our album, we don't get any money.
I like to think of Laura as being top of the chart, just like our album. He's like one of our influences. Which is Laura!
Yeah, I would say Laura. On our music, Laura's been quite a big influence.
Oh, and then beeping. She was like,
our first single, which was, well, that's what really broke us, you know, out of the pack of five-piece acoustic a cappella band. And yeah,
she does it all, Nathan.
Okay.
Without her, I don't think we could be where we are today.
Well, he's conservatory.
Well, yeah, my 30, so... we'd probably be at Tom's house.
Which isn't really a place that anyone wants to be, ever, to be honest.
Okay, thank you guys for your time. Do you want to say happy birthday?
Happy birthday,
our album.
Goodbye. So, Rosie and Becky, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
She's different, I hate her. No, it's her birthday, right? You can't say that. She's a lovely person and she's a great friend. She always seems to be there for everything and then just a nice person.
Becky?
Well, in all seriousness, to be fair, she is a lovely little lady and I don't know, she's just always kind of been there. I mean, even in little primary school when we were little children, and little, and she was always kind of there, but I wasn't really friends with her. She was always like on the yellow table. No, I was on the yellow table, she was on the geek table. And then I used to chase around the football pitch because I wanted to be like her.
Is there any memories you'd like to remind her of?
At your house, everyone else and nothing. Well, you wouldn't really understand because it was me and Laura. But that was fun.
Yeah, but he kept us in the team, didn't you?
That was the mile. The mile in primary. In middle school.
Yeah,
remember?
Yes, but
and then and Laura, we walked round, didn't we? We were like three-legged something.
Yeah,
you were the
yeah, you left me out.
And we were singing the F7 stuff as we
were
going.
That was fun.
Is there any special birthday message you want to give her?
We wish you a happy birthday, we wish you a happy birthday, we wish you a happy birthday and a merry life.
Brilliant. Okay, thank you very much for your time, both of you. Goodbye. So Bradley, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Well, she's a good friend, kind, funny, good at ice skating as well.
Okay, do you want to say happy birthday?
Happy birthday, Laura. I hope you enjoy the day. Sorry I can't be there.
Okay, cheers. Thank you very much for your time, Bradley. So, Tom, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
Wow. Laura's my friend. Laura's my friend. Happy birthday, Laura.
Okay, that's good. Thank you very much for your time.
Oh, hi there. You alright, Nathan?
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, cool.
So, what does Laura Martini mean to you?
What does Laura Martini mean to me? Right, let's start, I'm reading from a small script. Not that I don't care, because my memory's crap, But what does Laura mean to me? Well, to be honest, Laura means a lot to me. She's a great person, and I haven't known her for that long, but the time I have got to know her, I've learned that she's kind and generous, and has a good heart and great personality. In short terms, basically, she means the world to me. From the moment I met her, I could see why she's so popular, and straight she chose to be with me, to be honest. I've already said this, but I love her so much, and I could not think of a better person to be with right now.
Right, is there anything you want to say to her for a birthday message?
Well, just have a great birthday, Laura. Great 16th, you deserve it. And a whoop.
Okay, thank you very much for your time, Liz.
Alright.
So, what does Laura Martini mean to me? Well, over the years, I've gotten very well with her, and she's become one of my greatest friends. She's an all-round brilliant person, and I'd struggle to find a nicer person if I tried. Of course, like anyone, Laura has flaws, but because of how much everyone loves her, she has excused them, and we all mistake her for being perfect, or some kind of superwoman, because that's how she seems to us. She always makes an effort to be kind, even when I manage to annoy her. She puts up with an awful lot, especially in maths lessons, and I'm extremely grateful, as is everyone. And we're all grateful that we have a friend like Laura, who's just brilliant in every way. Maybe if I was good at poetry, I could find the words to describe Laura. Maybe if I was good at maths, I could figure out the equation that makes the wonder that is Laura. Maybe if I was good at science, I could conjure together an explanation to why Laura is so important to all of us. But unfortunately, I'm none of those. Well, it's hard to explain, Laura. It's like if you were to get all the best characteristics of everyone and shove them into one person, you'd end up with Laura. That's what you mean to us, Laura. Thank you for taking the time to watch this. This is Nathan Arm signing off. Goodbye.